small scale. Let me give you just one example. I live in an apartment building in Beijing. The janitor of my apartment building, I have some discussion with him. I found out, in addition to the salary he got from the property management company of my apartment building, he also get a guaranteed income from the local government of, another province where he is originally. I asked why? Because he's from Jiangsu province, and the collective, the whole village, the land is owned by collective, right? The land has been taken by the local government for industrial development, but they designed a scheme that for this village, the person who are above 40 years old, they will get a monthly payment until they die. But if they are less than 40 years, the government think they can find the job on their own. But for people who are above 40 years old, like the janitor in my apartment building, he get two income. One is unconditional, based on the former collective ownership of land. But another is the salary from the property management company. But in whole country, we don't know exact figure, but I think several million migrant workers in China may have this kind of arrangement, several million of them. But this depends on the local government, because you may read in news, recently big protest in so-called Wukan in Guangdong. So the peasant protest local government, which didn't give them any guarantee, and kind of help the big capitalist company to take over the land without this kind of. So it depends on the different local government. And so in this, finally, I would say the last, when the international basic income week last year, with my former student, Chen Furi, we organized this Chinese basic income network. We basically have a Chinese version of WhatsApp. So, but the Chinese version called WeChat, and we have 40 members, and our main activity so far is educational and research. We translated work by Philip Van Parijs, Real Freedom for All, and Carl's work, Basic Income as a Right to Single, and Sarah's also invite him to give a talk in Beijing, in his way back to India from Korea last year. Okay, thank you.
Brilliant. Thank you very much. Okay, one more.
Thanks.